everybody, and thank you so much for joining us on this episode of LinkedIn Live. My name is Melissa Palmer. I'm a senior technologist on the product strategy team here at Veeam, and I am joined by...
Hi, everyone. I'm Kirsten Stoner. Happy Friday. I'm a technical analyst at Veeam as well.
So how are you doing today, Kirsten? Are you excited for our show?
Yeah, I am excited. I do love me some Veeam ONE. I love talking about Veeam ONE. I think it provides a lot of benefits to our users. So I'm really excited to talk more about it today on LinkedIn Live.
So we've got that one thing. This is Veeam ONE version 11 Demo-Palooza. Before we get started, I want to remind you all what we do here on LinkedIn at Veeam. Drop a comment in the chat and let us know where you're tuning in from. We'll check the map a couple times and we'll give you a shout out and say hi. So without further ado, we have a couple slides just to set the stage and tell you a little bit more about Veeam ONE. And then we're gonna have Demo-Palooza. Let's get started. So as you know, we had a ton of releases here at Veeam yesterday, and the theme is, of course, turn it up to 11. You can kind of see the full Veeam solution stack and portfolio right here. And today we're going to be talking about monitoring and analytics. And if you notice, it's kind of sitting right on top of backup and replication. As we know, Veeam Backup and Replication is the engine that powers the car. But we're going to talk about Veeam ONE today, and especially in the context of backup and replication, and how it can give you unprecedented visibility into not only your Veeam environment, but your environment as a whole.
Yeah, so like Melissa mentioned, we definitely have that one thing that provides you the monitoring and analytics that you need. And it monitors Veeam Backup and Replication and the Veeam Agents, as well as any cloud workloads you are protecting with Veeam as well. You get that virtual monitoring for VMware vSphere, Microsoft Hyper-V, and you also get a deeper look into your data protection jobs, especially if you're using Veeam to protect your Nutanix AHV machines. And really it provides these five capabilities on the side, that real-time monitoring and alerting, the ability to take a look at your resources and optimize them for better performance, preparing for the future with capacity planning, and chargeback and billing capabilities for our service providers, and also intelligent diagnostics and automation. That one's always last on the list, but it's probably one of the more important and cooler features that Veeam ONE has in it. So we're going to be able to show you some of this today during our demos, but this is a great slide just for an overview of Veeam ONE, especially if you haven't heard about it before or you're not really sure what it offers.
So let's talk a little bit about Veeam ONE version 11. There are so many features and functionality that have been built into this. Kirsten and I usually start working with the Veeam products in the beta stage. We get our hands on it early. We kick the tires. We have a great time. But here are some of the really interesting things and some of the stuff we're actually going to show you today. Now, of course, if you've heard anything about Veeam in the last month or so, it's all about continuous data protection, what we call CDP. So we'll definitely be showing you a little bit about that today. We'll be showing you the improved user experience because we've got all new UIs with Veeam ONE for this version. And Kirsten, like, what are some of your favorites on this slide? What are some of the things that you think are your favorites when it comes to Veeam ONE version 11?
I think for me, it's hard to always choose my favorites because I would say that the Veeam ONE visibility within the data protection infrastructure is probably one of the best benefits of Veeam ONE because you're going to be able to monitor your backup jobs. You're going to be able to make sure that you're meeting your recovery point objectives, making sure that your virtual machines are protected and in case a disaster happens. And then you also have the ability to monitor infrastructure components, repositories, proxies, to make sure that like nothing is overloaded and you're meeting those backup windows. You're prepared for the future and you're not going to run out of that repository space. So it's like, I would say my favorite thing is the fact that Veeam ONE monitors our Veeam VNR, really giving users that visibility into the data protection view. And as well as service providers, Veeam ONE should be used by service providers as well because it's going to give you that monitoring and analytics for your infrastructure as well as, you know, being able to see that within the customer's infrastructure also. So I don't know. What's your favorite Veeam ONE feature? Melissa?
I can't pick a favorite feature, but I I have one little really super tiny itty bitty feature that I'll show you during my demo that's probably my favorite. I know I called you one day, Kirsten, on Teams. I was like, look what I just saw in Veeam ONE version 11. It's so cool. But you know, they're all kind of my favorites. And one thing that Veeam is really excellent about is that when we have a new feature come out in backup and replication, you can expect to see support for in Veeam ONE. A couple examples right here. CDP and extended Veeam agent support, including Veeam agent for Mac.
Yeah, it's almost like Veeam ONE's duty to incorporate all Veeam BNR features and provide that visibility. So yeah, I'm excited to, you know, dive deep into the demo and show you guys a little bit more. So
let's tell them about what we're going to show them today, Kirsten.
So first, we're going to take a look at the Veeam Backup and Replication integration, what you're going to be able to see within Veeam ONE, look at our Veeam Backup repositories, and then we're going to also talk about Veeam Intelligent Diagnostics, one of the really cool features within Veeam ONE to help you monitor your backup infrastructure. And then Melissa is going to show us.
I'm going to show you all that CDP in Veeam ONE, touch a little bit on public cloud data protection, and show you the Veeam ONE web client. But before we do that, let's head over to the map and see who's checked in with us. Okay, so we have Saudi Arabia, India, Southern California, the UK, Atlanta, Slovakia, Ohio, Serbia, Charlotte, Connecticut, Indiana, Portugal, Brazil, Denmark, Morocco, Croatia, Kenya, the Netherlands, Mexico City, Thailand, and Zambia. Wow, look at that map lighting up with green. If you haven't already, be sure to drop where you're located in the comments so we can give you a shout out and say hi. And once again, thank you so much for tuning in this Friday with us for Veeam ONE Demo-Palooza.
Wow, Thailand. What time is it in Thailand? Because it's like, what, 12 hours? So it has to be midnight there, right? I went to Thailand once and it was an adventure. I love me Thailand. So let's hop into our demo, a lab, and I hope everybody can see my screen. Can you see it? Is it looking
good? We're good, Kirsten.
Great. So like I mentioned, one of the cool things about Veeam ONE is really that visibility into the Veeam backup infrastructure. You can see in my Veeam ONE environment, this is just our lab environment here, but I do have multiple BNR servers added into my Veeam ONE. So if you are a company that has, you know, maybe some remote offices and you have a backup server at a couple different places, you actually have an overarching view of all of your backup jobs, and you're going to be able to see how everything's performing within Veeam ONE if you so choose to set it up that way. We can see our VM job status here. We have some jobs that have failed. We have some that have ended successfully. Then we have our agent jobs and policies. And then also we have our file backup job status. So a really nice overview of how our environment is doing, if our environment's protected and whatnot. So one of the things that we added with version 11 is really that enhanced agent support. So if I come over here within our agent jobs, you're going to easily be able to see, you know, which jobs are backing up these agents, and also which backup server they belong to, what type of agent is backing it up, and the duration of the job and average duration transfer data and so on. So really giving you a nice overview of all of your agent jobs in your environment. You can see I have some that have failed here as well. Unfortunately, I'm going to have to go back into my backups and see what's going on there. I can also check my alarms tab and make sure that everything is working as expected. If I switch into a single or a specific backup server, I'm also going to get an overview of how that backup server is performing. If I click into backup repositories here, I get to see how my repositories are doing, how many backup repositories I have. So I have 12 backup repositories in this environment, one scale out repository, and then I can see how much data is being stored on those backup repositories. File backups, you see I have some short-term file backups I'm storing, and et cetera. If I dive a little bit deeper into our scale backup repository, which is the ability to add, you know, that capacity tier, that archive tier to really take some of your backups up to object storage, I can take a look at what that's going to look like here as well. So I can see that it's scale out, and I can see my placement policy, which we're doing the data locality, and what type of extents I have. So I have one performance extents, which is normally, you know, an on-prem storage, a simple repository. And then I have one capacity extent here as well. So if we take a look down here, you can see that I have my object repository. It's set up to be immutable. So, you know, really protecting myself from accidental deletion or ransomware. I've set it for 30 days to make sure that I'm keeping those backups for 30 days safe. And you can just see how much space is being used and a little bit more information about that repository. So yeah, that's pretty much a pretty cool thing here. And then if I go back to the scale backup repository and I click on, you know, VMs, I can see which virtual machine is actually being sent to and stored in that scale backup repository. And I can also take a look at any computers that are utilizing that backup repository as well. So if you take a look here, this one is actually a standalone. So my agent is working in standalone, is not being even managed by BNR, and it's actually utilizing that backup repository as well. So another thing that we offer within Veeam, the Veeam ONE client, is reports. So if I come over here, I can actually run a report just to see how this scale-up backup repository is configured. And for the sake of time, I've actually already run this report and I have it saved on my in my Veeam ONE reports folder. So if you take a look, I hope you guys can see this pretty good here. You see in my whole backup infrastructure, I showed you I had multiple backup servers added in to my Veeam ONE. I have four scale backup repositories. I can see how many performance tiers, how many capacity tiers, and if I've set up that new archive tier as well. You can see your total capacity, the total free space, a little bit more statistics on what the extents are. You see that there are Windows, and I also have some SIF shares added in, and a little bit more overview of how that scale backup repository is configured and what data and how much data is, you know, being stored in that repository. So you can get this is a great report that you can actually set up. And especially if you're coming into an environment and you're not quite sure how things have been set up previously, if you're new, or if, you know, your boss wants to see how your scale backup repository is configured, you can easily run this report and be able to show him in a nice format how it is configured and how it's running. Last but not least, I want to talk about Veeam Intelligent Diagnostics. So if you're not familiar with Veeam Intelligent Diagnostics, it's basically the technology that allows Veeam ONE to take a look at your Veeam backup server and its components. So you think about proxies, repositories, and make sure that you don't have any common misconfiguration errors or performance issues that are occurring with those components that are going to overall affect your data protection strategy. So Veeam ONE basically has the ability to go into Veeam Backup and Replication and search through the logs of the Veeam Backup server and find any common misconfigurations that have been already identified by Veeam customer support. So as customers are calling in and experiencing issues, Veeam customer support is logging these issues and identifying these common misconfiguration errors to help streamline troubleshooting. So when you install Veeam ONE and you set up Veeam Intelligent Diagnostics, you basically have access to all these signatures within Veeam ONE alarms, and it's going to immediately notify you if your backup infrastructure setup is experiencing one of these common misconfiguration errors. And then from there, once one of these alarms is triggered, you actually have this Veeam Intelligent Diagnostic Signature ID. So when you have that error occur, you can actually just refer to that ID and immediately get that fix available to you. So really streamlining the whole intelligent whole customer support experience and the like. So if you haven't had, if you don't have Veeam ONE set up yet, especially if you have Veeam Availability Suite, you definitely need to take you definitely need to take advantage of this Veeam Intelligent Diagnostics feature, because not only does Veeam ONE be able to identify common misconfiguration errors, something that we're going to talk about a little bit later, is you can actually automate remediation actions. So a lot to Veeam ONE that can help you really get the most of your data protection strategy. So let's switch to, before we jump into Veeam ONE demo Melissa time.
Yeah, let's get a look at that map again.
Yeah,
Kirsten,
let's take a look at that map.
Who do we have?
So we have South Africa, Czech Republic, Northern California, Switzerland, Singapore, Germany, Guten Tag. So we got a lot of people joining from all over the world today, and that's always really exciting. I know I miss traveling all over the world and seeing everybody and talking to everybody. So thank you so much for joining us today. And are we ready to jump into the second demo?
Absolutely, let's do it. So friendly reminder, because we hit you with a lot of our Demo-Palooza information up front, the couple things that I'm going to show you today, or we're going to take a closer look at Veeam CDP in Veeam ONE, a little bit about public cloud data protection, because everybody loves the Veeam public cloud products. And then I'm going to show you the Veeam ONE web client, which you haven't seen yet today, as well as our awesome dashboard view and a custom dashboard that I actually built there. So we're in data protection view, and I have to show you my favorite silly little feature of Veeam ONE that I had to call Kirsten over one day, is this little thing right here. And I don't even know what this is called. But you can kind of minimize the navigation pane in data protection view and see everything in a bigger screen if you need a little screen, more screen real estate, because you're looking at data and charts and stuff. But I sat here for a good like 10 minutes and clicked this little carrot back and forth, basically. But let's take a look at our, let's take a look at my favorite server. So my favorite server right now is this one right here. We're going to come over to the VM protection tab, and we are going to see that I have a CDP policy running, and we can see a little bit about our policy here. We can see our job. We see green and running, which first of all, that's a great thing. But if we come over to alarms real quick, something else interesting we're going to see is one of our brand new alarms in Veeam 11, and that's Veeam CDP SLA compliance, right? So for whatever reason, my VM was not meeting its CDP SLA. I can tell you that was probably during the initial sync of the data when I first turned it on and needed some time to catch up and replicate all that data. But this is a really important notification because, of course, we always want to keep track of these types of things. What's really great is I could also get a little more information about when it happened. So I know, okay, 3:24 at 7:07 p.m. and then again at 7:38. I would want to go look at my vSphere environment, my environment as a whole, and see what I can kind of figure out if there's something wrong that I need to fix because I wasn't meeting my SLA. A new feature in CDP, and Kirsten and I actually set up CDP on Wednesday, and I can tell you that it took me longer to build a VM to protect with CDP than it actually took us to deploy Veeam CDP. There were about three simple steps, really easy. And one of them, of course, is deploying your Veeam CDP proxy. So if we come over here to summary, we can see all sorts of really useful information about our Veeam CDP proxy. Now, proxies are really what do most of the work with CDP, so we want to keep an eye on them. We look pretty good from the caching perspective, and we can see how much data that was transferred. That was my big initial sync on Wednesday I told you about. But then, of course, I can come over to CPU charts, memory, disk to see how everybody's going, to see how this proxy's performance is. And, of course, I can change the time on the graph to whatever time period I need to look at. Again, we do have alarms as well. Luckily, nothing's triggered because I have this beautiful brand new CDP environment. But if there was, there's actually an alarm out of the box to monitor our proxy for us and tell us if it seems to be having problems or if we need to change anything. So it's really useful to see all of your CDP data right in Veeam ONE. The next thing I want to take a look at is cloud data protection. So I'm going to go to a different backup and replication server right now. I'm going to come over to cloud backup policies, and you can see all of my policies right here. So I have AWS and Azure running. I can expand this a little bit here. I can see what VMs I'm protecting, last snapshot, last backup. If I had replication enabled in AWS, I could see my last replication information, but I'm not using that here. And again, besides just being able to go in and see your jobs all in one place, we also have a ton of wonderful alarms to let you know if something's going wrong in your environment. So let's see, I know I have one someplace here. If I come to cloud, let's just put in cloud. Or I fixed my alarm, but I had an alarm that was triggering when my cloud data protection job was failing. And the alarm actually told me that basically my problem was with my proxy configuration and I needed to fix it. So that was another really super simple, easy way to do it. And again, it just kind of belongs here, right? So we're going to see CDP in our VM protection right here. So it's a VM, right? We're protecting it like we're protecting a VM with a backup or a replica job. Like you saw when I switched to this server, I can see the massive list of all my jobs and everything that's wrong. And then right in here, I have this new cloud backup policies tab with my Amazon and my Azure to see what's going on. Of course, we can leverage all our reports right here. We have some reports for CDP, so we can actually get a VM CDP SLA compliance report and public cloud data protection. My favorite report, which I'm not going to show you today, but it's my favorite, so you should go download Veeam ONE, try it, and try it for yourself. Protected VMs. It tells you what VMs are protected in your environment, but more importantly, it also shows you what's not protected in your environment, so it's a handy report to have. Now I want to switch over to the Veeam ONE web client. Again, brand new UI, HTML5 interface, really slick look and feel, and this is my default dashboard where I can see so much information about my environment. So let's start with Veeam Backup and Replication real quick. I've got a really good view that's going to load of basically everything that is wrong in my environment. And I can tell you, this is a disaster by design, because I'll never forget I was doing a demo for a customer once and they're like, you know, I want to see stuff that's wrong because everything looks too good in your environment. So this one is a bit of a disaster. And I get useful information like about my backup infrastructure. Here's all my backup servers, my repositories, my proxies. Job status, I have a lot of failed stuff I need to look at, top jobs by duration, protected VMs, and that kind of ties back into that unprotected VM. That's my favorite thing in Veeam ONE as well. And, you know, there's just so much useful data in here, but we also have the ability to build custom dashboards. Now, for those of you who know me and don't know me, one of my things is disaster recovery. I talk about it all the time. So what I did actually is I built myself a nice little custom dashboard in Veeam ONE to look specifically at my disaster recovery environment. So I have this first tab over here that's going to load orchestration plan one. And I apologize for some of this slowness loading. We're in a shared lab environment. We got a lot of stuff going on. But this is all of the VMs I put in a disaster recovery plan. And if I actually logged into my orchestrator server over here, which I'm not going to, it would be yelling at me and saying, hey, you put all these VMs in a plan, but guess what? You're not protecting 27 of them. I can't find the backup. I can't find the replica. You need to go and fix that. Another great thing I have is my Site 2 data center overview. Let's face it, no one ever worries about their disaster recovery data center until something's wrong, but we have to keep an eye on it. So here's all the stuff that's basically wrong in my vSphere environment, my disaster recovery site, and it's quick and easy for me to keep a look at. We have my backup and replication job duration. Of course, in the event of a disaster, I want to make sure that I'm meeting my RPOs, right? Orchestrator is great about checking your RPOs for you, but I like to have this view to kind of keep an eye on things. And if I notice my RPO is creeping up because my job duration is creeping up, that might be an indicator that I should go back to Veeam ONE and take a look at my proxies and make sure they're performing well and they're not overloaded and kind of dive a little deeper into what could possibly be wrong in my environment and why is my window creeping up? I don't want to potentially have any issues with my RPO. And then finally, here is a closer view at my vSphere host and my Site2 cluster. And I love this view. I built it last night and I can look at my storage, which is always important. And Orchestrator does a great job of that. But my CPU, my memory, right? So you can actually see when I turned on CDP because I wasn't doing anything in my cluster whatsoever. I built a brand new little nested vSphere cluster to test with, And then I turned on CDP and now my hosts are actually doing things. So that's kind of what this spike up was good. So this is a really good view. Again, in these CAN dashboards, we have so many different things that you can look at, VNR, vSphere, and build your own. Now, we have a ton of reports in Veeam ONE. These are all of the reports out of the box that you can run on demand or have scheduled and sent to you. I can spend hours doing this, so I just want to quickly highlight one of our newest reports in version 11. That's the VM and computer protection history. And guess what? That's exactly what it sounds. It is all the data about the VMs in your environment and their data protection status. I mean, I love this report. It gives you so much information. It tells you what server it is, what backup job it is, what server you're running it on, what repository. It's basically all the data you could ever want about your Veeam backup and replication environment in one handy little report. And again, I could export that, I could save it, and I could have it scheduled to run on demand. So that is my version of Veeam ONE version 11, some of my favorite features. And what we're gonna do now is we have a couple more slides just to wrap up real quick. So we have our other favorites, right, Kirsten? Like, I know we hit on remediation actions very briefly, but here are some of our other favorite things in Veeam ONE. Now, other than remediation actions, because we both love it, what's your favorite in this list?
I would definitely think what's cool about Veeam ONE is that you do have, you know, the customizable alarms, being able to go into the alarms and adjust them to fit the needs of your data center. Every data center is different. So being able to adjust them to be triggered for different resource utilization thresholds, being able to build your own alarms based on processes and services. That's just really cool to do. And like with even with reports, like being able to go in and build reports, being able to be sent reports so you don't have to necessarily open Veeam ONE web client to, you know, access a report, having that schedule to be able to be emailed to you. I think that's just very a useful feature that, you know, it can become in handy in any situation.
Exactly. And one thing we didn't really spend a lot of time on today is business view categorization. We have an intelligent grouping mechanism in Veeam ONE that can let you group your VMs based on anything you could possibly ever want to group them on, a number of criteria. You could even use vSphere tags. But once you build out these application categories or these categories that make sense for you and your organization, then you can have alarms designed to monitor those categories and reports designed to run on those categories. So besides getting a really good look of your whole environment and its overview, you can also get super granular and get reporting and alarming and alerting on your really important mission critical applications or basically anything you want. Veeam ONE is super flexible. Now we love our remediation actions. And we have a number of different things that have built-in remediation actions, backup job disabled. So one of the remediation actions for that one is, hey, enable the backup job. That's a really good one, right? VM with no backup and no replica. So VM with no backup, you have the ability to actually add that VM to like a catch-all backup job. I like to create one just to run once a day. So I can make sure that I don't have any gaps in my data protection. Kirsten, do you have a favorite when it comes to alarms with predefined remediation actions?
I definitely would say the VM with no backups, because sometimes, you know, you're not hitting your RPOs, and if that virtual machine isn't being backed up and you need it to be backed up, you can automatically, you know, schedule a back, like put in a backup job, run a quick Veeam zip, and have that protection for that virtual machine instantaneously within Veeam ONE. So I definitely think that's my favorite out of all of them. The orphan VM backup snapshot one, just being able to automatically remove snapshots that are sticking around is also one of my favorites.
That one's good too.
So there's a lot of, they're all very handy. What is cool too about remediation actions, I know you're saying, oh, these are the only actions I can perform. No, you can actually write a custom script as well to perform an action within Veeam ONE to remediate an alarm. So just wanted to add that in there real quick.
Absolutely. So remember, join us on Twitter, #VeeamONECatchOfTheDay, Veeam ONE COTD. You'll find us sharing all of our fun things on Veeam ONE. And we have a couple key takeaways for you today. First and foremost, download a 30-day free trial of Veeam Availability Suite or Veeam Backup and Replication and Veeam ONE, right? That's the suite, the two products combined. Go download one. It's super simple to set up and get running. And Kirsten, what else do we have going on?
We have, join us for Veeam ONE Catch of the Day on Twitter, hashtag Veeam ONE COTD. And then download our white paper as well. I was actually just taking a look at our map here as one last time. We had, you know, Spain, Texas, Italy, UAE. So in total, we reached about 28 countries and 10 U.S. states. So once again, thank you all for tuning in today and watching our Veeam ONE Demo-Palooza, because it's definitely been a fun one for me.
It has, and we have another couple of other great events coming up as well. Monday, don't miss JD Wallace from Pure Storage and Jason Buffington, because they're going to talk all about some of the wonderful Pure and Veeam goodness. That's always an exciting one to have. They're great together, basically. And then, Kirsten, I hear this World Backup Day thing is coming up. Can you tell us a little bit more about that?
Yeah, World Backup Day is on March 31st, and we're definitely going to celebrate because we love to have a backup. And so make sure that you join our LinkedIn Live celebration. It's at 11 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Sorry about that. We're going to have a special guest, DDA Von Hoy, is joining Rick Vanover, and they're going to talk about everything backup, free swag, Bose gadgets. Honestly, I never know if I pronounce Bose right. So yeah, definitely check it out and make sure you register to attend. It should be fun.
Thank you so much today to all of our viewers for joining me about learning more about that one thing, Veeam ONE. And Kirsten, thanks for joining me today. I hope everybody has a wonderful Friday and a wonderful weekend. And Veeam will see you back next week on Monday.